eyes, they're kind of like reddish. So that's how strong this stings, you guys. It's kind of like oily in a way. It almost feels like it hasn't even been cleansed.
Hello guys, today I'm gonna try out the very famous Cetaphil Daily Facial Cleanser for one entire week and actually see how well it cleanses my skin, if it maybe irritates it, dries it out, or if it actually cures my acne and removes the sebum. That would be amazing. But anyways, on the bottle, Cetaphil says this is actually targeted for normal to oily skin people, and also that it removes excess oil without drying, and it is clinically proven to deep clean skin. Now this is very much reminding me of what the oil skin cleanser, also by Cetaphil, is supposed to do. So at this point, like, we definitely have to see which one is worth it. This is one of the questions that will have to be answered in this video. And by the way, I have tried that cleanser in this video right here, so if you want to go watch that later. But anyways guys, I'm kind of intrigued now, I will say that. So without further ado, let's get to experimenting with this cleanser, shall we?
Okay guys, so this is what my skin looks like on day one. I'm only wearing a little bit of mascara, brow product, and a little bit of highlighter, but I'm not wearing any foundation, so you can really see what my skin is actually looking like. And I mean, it's feeling a little bit dry, especially right here, like chin and jawline. So dry, you guys. But also, I'm having a little bit of like blackheads. I don't know if you'll be able to tell on camera. And also, as you can see, it's kind of a little bit oily, just a little bit greasy, we shall call it that.
I'm very disgusted, to be quite honest with you.
But anyways, guys, I really don't know what is this supposed to be like, because I'm imagining it not being a gentle skin cleanser from Cetaphil, but not even an oily skin cleanser. So really, what is this? Like, is it that in between? Guess we'll have to see throughout this experiment. But anyways, first thing I want to see is the consistency. Okay, so it's definitely exactly the same as the oily one, like that jelly, runny consistency. The smell is exactly the same as the oily cleanser. Anyways, now I'm gonna emulsify it and start massaging it on my skin and really see if it's capable to remove that mascara first on. Ooh, okay, so it's stinging my eyes, guys. So definitely pay attention not to, you know, let it get into your eyes like I did. Okay, guys, so I've added quite a little bit of water to see if it would foam up, but it's literally not, like, there's nothing basically. And also, like, on my skin, it definitely doesn't feel tingling or anything. It is not stripping. It's more so kind of a little bit moisturizing, that little in between. It's kind of like oily in a way. Okay guys, so my face is now cleansed. I don't know if you can tell, but my eyes, they're kind of like reddish. So that's how strong this stings, you guys. Definitely pay attention. But my skin is not feeling moisturized, but it's not even feeling like stripped of anything. It almost feels like it hasn't even been cleansed, as in, like, you know, it's totally fine. Like, it just feels normal. Like, I just cleansed it with water. You guys, anyways, these were my only first impressions. There is definitely a lot we still have to see and find out about this, so definitely let's keep watching. Okay guys, so it's day two, but before I wash my face again, I first want to read with you guys the ingredient list so we can better understand what is actually in this and if it actually is good and what it can do for our skin. The first ingredient is actually going to be glycerin. Now glycerin is really hydrating and moisturizing ingredient, so that's amazing. Then there is hydrogenated glycerol palmitate. Now you guys, if you watch my channel and this is not the first video that you watch me, you know that I taught you guys a little tip, and that is whenever you see GLY in any ingredient, that means that it's glycerin based. Therefore, once again, this is going to be hydrating and moisturizing for the skin. Then there is butylene glycol. The same rule applies, you guys. So really, the first three ingredients, they're just all very hydrating and moisturizing ingredients for your skin. So I feel like this is going to be very gentle, almost as hydrating as like a CeraVe hydrating cleanser at this point. Then we continue reading. There's actually going to be sodium lauryl sarcosinate. And now guys, I'm really happy that Cetaphil went with this cleansing agent, because this ingredient is actually what like draws out the impurities and dirt from your skin. So you definitely need cleansing agents and cleansers. However, this is very gentle and soothing to the skin, whereas like for example sodium lauryl sulfate, that can be very damaging and sometimes irritating for the skin. But however, I also see sodium laureth sulfate, which is the nicer sister of sodium lauryl sulfate. So once again, I'm very happy with your choice, Cetaphil. Then continuing to read, I see glycerol colcate. Now this not only is glycerin based, but also colcate reminds you of coconut oil. And coconut oil not only has amazing antibacterial and antifungal properties, so it's going to be amazing for soothing your skin from acne and redness from the acne, but it can also be moisturizing. And then there's also fragrance. You guys know how I feel about fragrance. I do not like fragrance in any of my products because it's just useless. Like, it be just sensitizing your skin for nothing. Like, if you want to smell nice, just wear perfume, sis. Cetaphil, you really played down on me with that.
No.
Then let's continue reading, and then I see hydrogenated castor oil. Castor oil is amazing for the skin because it really balances the moisture levels in the skin, and it really helps your skin to retain moisture. So really, I see this cleanser as just a hydrating cleanser at this point, even though yesterday I assumed it was an oily skin cleanser. And like, I don't see how this is targeted for oily skin people, because like, if you look at the packaging, it literally says normal to oily skin. However, this to me is just a very hydrating formula. All right, Cetaphil, how is it gonna remove the excess sebum? Because that is what you're claiming on the bottle, yet I don't see that in the ingredient list.
I wanna know that.
Okay.
I really want to know that.
So we definitely have to see if this can actually deliver what it's supposed to now. Okay, guys, so it's day 5. I've just woken up. This is what my skin is looking like. I mean, as you can see, it's very kind of moisturized already. It's not feeling that tight anymore like it used to. I am feeling a little bit of dryness right here on the chinny chin chinny sure. But apart from that, the skin is all good. So I definitely feel like I'm liking this cleanser. Now, as you can see, I'm also using it in the morning, just because you can literally use every cleanser both at morning and night. There are no rules about that. But you guys, I feel like already now I've kind of already figured out what this cleanser is all about. However, I will still use this for another 2 days just to finish the week for the sake of the video, and then I will wrap this up and tell you guys my final thoughts and opinion. And Miss Cetaphil, I have something to say that you don't think I will, so you definitely have to keep watching, because girl, there is some tea that has to be sipped.
Hi Cetaphil, oh my god, thank you so much for coming. Nice to see you again. I know it must be a little bit hard for you to travel now, especially since we're this quarantine, this lockdown thing, so you might be a little bit bored, and also it was hard for you to come all the way here from America. First, I'm feeling positive, so I will start with the positive things and the things that I liked about this. First off, the formula of this cleanser is just amazing. I mean, Cetaphil, you always snap with the formulas. It is nothing new, nothing unheard of. Cetaphil is the girl when it comes to formulas.
Period.
I mean, if we just take a quick look, we can see a lot of moisturizing ingredients. We don't see sodium lauryl sulfate. That is definitely a plus. You actually went with sodium lauryl sulfate and not with the evil sister. Then we also see castor oil and nourishing and soothing oils, coconut oil. So really, the formula is just amazing. The only thing that I wouldn't like is the fragrance. Cetaphil, did you have to go with the fragrance in this? Okay, it's quite nice. It does smell cleansy, kind of like fragrancy, you know, like you just cleanse your skin and it's just all, ooh, it's so smooth and clean and fresh and bougie. Because also, I just went to grab my gentle skin cleanser and my oily skin cleanser. The gentle skin cleanser smells all right, and it is fragrance-free. So there really was no need for you to put fragrance in it. Now, I get your thought process. Like, people with sensitive skin and dry skin usually cannot stand fragrance in their skincare because it does irritate and sensitizes them, whereas oily skin types tend to, you know, support better fragrance. So I get where you're coming from. However, it would have been nice just if it was fragrance-free. Another positive that I really liked was the consistency and overall, like, the experience of using this cleanser. Yes, yes, Cetaphil, yes. So it was just the gel consistency reminded me very much of the oily skin cleanser for this. If you were to ask me though if these were exactly the same, I mean, consistency wise, they're quite similar. I will say that.
That dress looks awful close to mine.
Somebody must be jealous.
I look great. I'm not jealous, Hoops, and you know it.
But this is a whole other video because I'm actually planning on making a video of comparing all of these three cleansers together. So watch an eye out when that comes out if you are interested and want to see more of really what is perfect for your skin type. But going back to the tracks of this. So Cetaphil, we said that I like the formula. We said that I like the consistency. So this is an overall a very nice cleanser. However, now comes the negatives, and I think that I maybe don't agree with you on first point I want to make. And I want to address with you and really talk and see your point of view as to why you decided to put this on the bottle. And there are many things wrong with what you put on the bottle. Let me just straight up address it right here, right now, in front of all my randoms. Normal to oily skin. Please explain. I mean, normal, yes, definitely, because this is just a nice cleanser that is right in the middle. It's not super nourishing and super hydrating, but it's not even stripping. But so why did you say to oily skin? And also underneath it, it says removes excess oil without drying. I don't agree with this statement because it did not decrease the sebum in my skin. I have tried other foaming cleansers in the past for oily skin types, like the CeraVe Foaming Cleanser, maybe also the Cetaphil Oily Skin Cleanser. Those do a pretty good job of removing the oils and reducing the sebum in your skin. This, it simply does not have the vernacular. It simply just does not have the flavor, the production, nor the budget to pull off such thing that you said. Here's the thing, let me explain to you, Cetaphil, what an oily skin person really is. Us oily skin types, we are very much caliente, okay? We're like exotic. We are kind of like the Latinos, the Greeks, the Italians, the Spanish. We have passion, amore, festas. We love our telenovelas and our series and sitcoms. We are very dramatic, and therefore our skin literally resembles that. Our skin is also dramatic. She likes to cry a lot. Her tears are the sebum, so she cries oil. So after this very accurate analogy,
you should be going home anyway.
I really think that if you were to target this for normal to oily skin types, as you have said, and also to remove excess oil, I feel like this formula is just way too gentle. Our skin can really handle a lot more, and I feel like with this, you just went on a safe spot. This to me, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, Cetaphil. This to me really reminds me of the Gentle Skin Cleanser. It has so many moisturizing and hydrating ingredients. However, there is really nothing that is supposed to take away the sebum. What ingredient did you think was gonna reduce the oil in our skin? Because the ingredient list of this is just very much similar to this one right here. Like, to me, they're basically sisters from a different mister. So please, if you have oily skin and you are looking to buy this because it says to oily skin and removes excess oil, please do not stay away from it. Put this back on the rack.
She should have put them back on the rack, and she should never even purchase them because she was unqualified.
Because it is simply not fit for an oily skin person. She has been lied several times, and she thinks that she can handle an oily skin person, but she really cannot. She does not possess the vernacular.
She just doesn't have the vernacular that she thinks she possesses. Somebody lied to her several times and told her that she was fly, hot, and sexy, and beautiful, and she's nothing like that. She's nothing of the sort.
Cetaphil, you know what? This reminds me just very much of one of them rich girls that they really grew up into money, and just they basically have handed everything on a silver plate, and whenever they do like the smallest things and they achieve the smallest thing, like, look mommy, I cleaned a mirror, and they're like, oh my god, good job, here's a Chanel bag. This is it. This is it. She thinks she can handle oily skin. She cannot. She don't. If you have instead normal skin, I feel like this could definitely be that good Judy cleanser for you. Let me tell you why. Dry skin people are gonna have this one. Oily skin people are gonna have the oily skin cleanser. But this, it would be perfect for someone who doesn't have any skin issues, normal to oily skin, in a way that they don't necessarily feel like they need a cleanser to remove their oils, because some of us actually like having that dewy, glowy, oily, greasy look. I know that I do. I like to glow in a form of grease, but I like it still. Or also on the other side, for someone with normal to a little bit of dry skin who doesn't need a really moisturizing cleanser because maybe it does find them to break them out, then maybe you would be better off with using this, because this is still going to provide that moisture and it's still going to be gentle on your skin without maybe being too much and overpowering. So this is really that good spot in the middle. It's oily skin people can still use this, because as I always say in my videos, I really like to go in with my morning skincare routine, but for really gentle, because at night we do cleanse our skin and we put on our nighttime routine, Hopefully, we don't go to bed with no makeup on so our skin is just fresh and dewy. We then go to bed, and then we literally stay there the whole entire time. Unless you sleepwalk, and maybe you go somewhere and you get your face dirty and you wait. I don't know what you do in your sleep, sis. Or maybe you don't sleep at all because you got your mans there and maybe you sweat a little. Then in that case, all right. But if you're just sleeping and being a good girl and being a good child of God, then when you wake up, your skin is still gonna be cleansed. There is literally no need for you to use a stripping cleanser. There is no need for you to use this. Therefore, this is where this comes in. At night, go ahead and use your foaming cleanser. And now instead, for my normal skin types, you can literally use this both in the morning and at night. And now for my dry skin people, instead, it's gonna be the opposite as the oily skin people. So you are gonna use this at night. So this is not as gentle as this one. So maybe in the morning, I would rather use this, which is gonna deliver a lot of that moisture. Keep going with that juiciness and moisture that you put on the night. And then at night, after you come back from a day of work and you have a little bit of dirt and you have a little bit of makeup as well, and this simply wouldn't take off the makeup that good because I have tried this too, and let me tell you, it's not gonna do the job. So this can take away the makeup a lot better than that one. So this, once again, could be a perfect for you in the night. As you can see, this literally can work for any skin type if you know your way around. And really, there are basically kind of no rules in skincare. Like, once you figure out your skin and you know what's best for you, you can see that you can mood this in the morning. At night, you can use this for if you have dry skin, if you have oily skin. You don't need to listen to whatever the brand Cetaphil is telling you, because sometimes she can be deceiving. But anyways, you guys, now after having said all this and my train thought process, the question that y'all been wondering is, Mateo, will you be using this in your skincare routine once this experiment is over? I already answered this question, and that is yes. I definitely do recommend this. And so, you guys, as always, I will tell you where I bought this from. I actually bought this from Amazon, especially now that we're all quarantining. Also, even if you're not in quarantine anymore and you're watching this in the future, why would you step outside of your house? Nothing good ever happens outside. The sun, the smog, the people, no. And I will tell you that I bought this for, I have the price right here, £12.69 Royal British Pounds. And actually, this is for 237 mLs or 8 fluid ounces for my US folks out there. I actually think that it's worth the money. I have used this for a week and honestly, it is still completely full. I honestly think that from a daily use, you could easily get away with using this for 2 months or so. So if you want to go buy it, I made it real easy for you because I always got you covered. So I actually found the cheapest part listing that I could find, both as Amazon US and Amazon UK, and I linked it down below in the pinned comment. So if you want to go buy it, all you gotta do is literally click that link. But anyways, to my people who are still watching, and I said people because if you have not yet subscribed, you are not yet one of my randoms. You have not earned the title and the privileges that we get as being part of this family. Us randoms, we have a special spot in the skincare heaven. So really, why don't you consider subscribing to the bag so you don't miss any of my uploads. If you have any concerns with your skin, like maybe you're dealing with acne, girl, let me tell you, I have dealt with acne myself a lot in the past, and I have finally found a skincare that works for me. Or also, if you're starting to see wrinkles and fine lines and you're all about anti-aging and obsessed about that, girl, let me tell you, same. The signs of aging and wrinkles, and I simply am not gonna participate in the thing that is aging. So really, as you can see, there's a spot for you in here. So if you wanna join, then join the random family. We would love to have you here. Mwah. And also, if you want to see maybe a little bit more behind the scene, then what you should do is actually follow me on my Instagram right here, because we keep the same energy there. We actually bump it up a notch even more. We're even more crazier. I know it's hard to get even more crazy, but we do. You can also DM me if you maybe have any issues with your skin that you want to talk one-on-one privately on, and maybe you want some help with then go. DM me. But anyways, to my randoms who are still watching, you know what time of the video it is now. It's time for the Italian word of the video. And since this video was all about the Cetaphil gel, hello, excuse me, don't you dare bump me on my face. Rude. Since we were talking about this rude daily facial cleanser by Cetaphil, the Italian word of the video, and I actually mentioned caliente. Us Italians, we're very much just passionate. Therefore, the Italian word of the video is going to be passione, which is passion in English. Passionate is appassionato in Italian. There you go. Now you know both. You are welcome. So now, if you maybe find yourself in Italy in your sleep, because maybe you're sleepwalking and you walk all the way to Italy, that can happen. We never know. You are definitely gonna need a nudie skin cleanser for that after you come back from the walk, because that walk is gonna make your skin dirty. So you definitely gonna need this. And this in the morning. You might find a really handsome Italian man's or women's or plants or whatever you are into. We don't care about that. What we care is that when you kiss them, you are gonna say, give me a passionate kiss, which is dammi un bacio appassionato. I got you covered in love, in skincare, in everything. As you can see, you would lose if you were not to subscribe. But also, speaking of not wasting your time, sis, I'm gonna make two videos right here for you. So there's no need for you to go watch one of the two videos they are recommended in that column. They simply do not have the vernacular and what they possess that what my videos have. So really what you should do is watch one other of these two videos that I suggest for you. They're just gonna be as informative, as funny, as entertaining, as just life-changing as this video was. But also remember to be random and always be random. Life is better being randoms, I tell you, and I do not lie.